Hey guys, it's Jordan from Just Tesla, where we talk just Tesla. And today we're gonna talk about why we didn't order full self-driving. As you may have seen from the old video, we ordered a bare bones Tesla. So no options, absolutely nothing. The cheapest and most basic Tesla you can order. We didn't know whether we wanted to order the full self-driving option. It was actually quite a hard decision for us to make, and eventually we decided not to go with it after all the research we did on it. I want to share with you guys today why we won't be ordering the full self-driving option and why I don't think you should if you live in the UK. Right now, you shouldn't do it right now. And this is based for just the UK. That's where we've done the research for it, and that's where these numbers and statistics are from. So, what is full self-driving? When you buy the Tesla, autopilot is included. And that's like an extremely advanced version of lane assist. Some cars have it, like they have a lane assist. They'll keep the distance from the car in front, and they'll keep the car in back. They've got obstacle avoidance. And it's like Tesla's version of that, but it's extremely advanced and it's beating everybody else in the market. But what Tesla also offers is full self-driving option. And what that is if basically imagine if you wasn't in the car, if you were not sitting in the car and there was nobody in the car, the vehicle could get to a destination by itself. It could take off from your house and get to a destination by itself. That's what the technology is capable of doing. And they have the technology capable of doing that right now, but not all countries, not all states, not all places are accepting of it. And there's a few little road bumps for Tesla to get around. Now in the United States, it looks like that's gonna be moving quite fast. In the UK, it's a slightly different story. That's what we're gonna get into today. So the price on the website right now is £5,800 for the option of full self-driving. The car already came with autopilot, so this was a decision between autopilot and full self-driving. Now, the other thing that Elon has said will happen with the price of full self-driving is it's going to increase over time. And it's not if, it's more like when. Because it will happen, they will increase the price of the technology. Right now it's at £5,800, it has been cheaper I'm pretty sure, and it's gonna increase by quite a substantial amount. But in my opinion, what you are doing is giving Tesla a 0% loan. Now, if you run a company, or you're savvy with your money, you should be able to turn that £5,800 into something else. And it should, that £500, £800 should increase over time. And I feel like our money will increase accordingly with Tesla. And that's why I don't want to just give that money away right now. The money will actually probably end up in Tesla shares and end up increasing along with the full self-driving. And hopefully our money would have outworked how much they increase it by the time we need it. The reason we wanted full self-driving so much is because the possibilities are amazing. And I think Tesla getting this first, if they manage to nail this, will increase the prices of Teslas. The market, the aftermarket value of Teslas will be unbelievable. It'll be fantastic for climate change. It'll be fantastic for Tesla as a company and for the future of vehicles. It absolutely, when you think of the possibilities of full self-driving, it absolutely blows your mind. You basically could create a taxi service, the world's biggest taxi service, like Uber, but you're taking the drivers out of the equation. The cost savings, it means that cars are accessible for everybody. We've got taxis. For us personally, we would be able to use it as a taxi to earn income for ourselves. We would be able to use it for airport drops, which are very important for us. They cost a lot of money to park your car up, pay for the parking at the airport whilst you're away, come back, hope that your car's not been damaged. Whereas a Tesla would be able to drive you to the airport, drop you off, and then when you need picking up, you'd arrange for it, it'd drive itself home, and when you need picking up, it'd come back out to you, pick you up. It would be unbelievable. Another amazing thing I can't wait for is to be able to go to sleep in a car. Imagine you had a long journey, you could jump in a Tesla, input your location, fall asleep, wake up. Especially living in the UK, pretty much anywhere is accessible from where we live, which is in the middle of the UK. So you could input any location, have a little doze off, and wake up where you need to be. And you could even, if they manage to put the infrastructure in place You could even input locations like Paris and set it so you set off at night, went to bed, and you'd wake up in the morning in Paris. That's if they built the infrastructure with the Eurotunnel and Eurotunnel allowed it full self-driving. But if full self-driving became such a widespread thing, that eventually would be in place as well. But things like that blow my mind. Click and collect. In the UK, click and collect for shopping is a big thing. So instead of you having to leave your home, you do your click and collect shopping, your Tesla would drive out to your local Asda or Tesco, your car would arrive, they would load your shopping into your car, you'd still be sat at home, the car would come back and deliver your shopping. So stuff like that's amazing. And then lastly, just this is mainly for Tesla, the cost savings of the full self-driving inside their infrastructure is amazing. If they are selling hundreds of thousands of vehicles, every single vehicle needs to be driven off the production line, loaded onto a transporter truck, a boat, or to the collection center. These things, they have people, and all car companies, they have people from the service centers sit in the vehicles and drive them to places. And it happens so much. Logistically, moving vehicles is quite difficult. If the cars drove themselves, they would load themselves onto boats, they would load themselves onto transporter trucks, they would load themselves into the service center. And the amount of man hours it would save just in that alone would be unbelievable for the company. So I think it's fantastic. I love the technology. I love where it's heading. I love what it's capable of doing. But, and this is a big but, if you live within the UK, it just doesn't look that great for us right now in terms of full self-driving and the laws around it right now. It doesn't look fantastic. And that's what, when we looked into it, that's what made us decide against it. So within the UK at the moment, the most up-to-date information I can find is that they will be allowing driverless trials to start in around 2021. Now that's next year, but if anyone who lives within the UK knows how slow infrastructure is, they know how slow these things take to process. I mean, look at Brexit right now. These sort of things take so long that it's just, for me, I don't have hope of it happening any quicker than that. And that's trials. So we genuinely don't know how long it's going to take. Now, at the moment, there's a petition that's been passed around, and this is for EU law, but at the moment, the UK will be a part of that. It's EU law. It's got 8,500 signatures. We've signed it ourselves. I'll link it in the description. It needs 10,000 signatures to be passed on to the EU Parliament and to be considered. So that and that is to consider full self-driving as an option and try and advance the pace at which we reach it. With that being said, it still doesn't look that fantastic. And I personally would prefer to keep the money myself, not have that out of pocket, and make it useful for my business. And hopefully that money would grow at a faster rate than the price increases of the full self-driving by the time full self-driving comes into place. Now, if something more locked in comes in, like the UK government talk about that they will most definitely be doing full self-driving in 2022 or 2021, they've agreed that they will be doing it, then I can understand purchasing the full self-driving option prior to the date. And that, for me, that would just be a more of a business decision to save on costs and try and judge Tesla's price increase versus how much I could earn on that money myself. And if the maths worked out, I'd probably choose the full self-driving and have that reserved for when it comes out in the UK. At the moment in the UK as well, it's very incentivized to buy electric cars. So it's always worth keeping an eye out for what they're doing. They've just changed the benefit in kind tax recently. They're changing lots of things around because it looks like we really are trying to push electric vehicles, especially around London as well. But at the moment, there's not much mention of full self-driving. With that being said, Brexit is happening. So the EU laws may not apply to us soon. And the UK may come up with their own laws and they may come up with their own full self-driving regulations. So who knows where we're going to be at the end of this year? We don't know what's around the corner. But for now, in my opinion, it is not worth buying the full self-driving option. And I would save your money and just take it on the chin when the price increase comes, and hopefully you've used your money to your advantage to make sure that you've covered the price increase itself. The other thing is if they allow regulation in the UK, they like to soft roll it out. A lot of regulations in the UK, they soft roll out. So they'll probably only allow full self-driving option with an occupant, and an occupant must touch the wheel every 30 seconds, which is pretty much autopilot. With that being said, these are just my thoughts and feelings. And if you like the video, please like the video. And if you want more stuff like this, please subscribe. We have ordered our Tesla Model 3. It will be coming soon. We will be filming absolutely every single process of it. If you're interested, please stay tuned and subscribe. And if you are interested in purchasing a Tesla Model 3 or a Tesla Model S or X, please go see our previous videos on how to buy them for a limited company for the UK. And also, if you are interested and you want to support the channel, please use the link below. It gives us 1,000 free miles and it gives you a free 1,000 free miles. And it's like a referral program they're doing. And it will really help support the channel and really do appreciate it. Thank you. That's Jordan from Just Tesla. Thanks for tuning in. And that's everything, guys. And until next time.